Evening, morning, afternoon, whatever time of the day that you are watching this Bible study video. It's good to have you with us and join us as we continue to look at Psalm, and that should actually say Psalm 23 verse 2 because we did verse 1 last week. Here is what verse 2 tells us. It says, "He lets me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters." Psalm 23 is probably the most recognized, memorized, utilized verse chapter of the Bible. It's used by believers, unbelievers, and we know that, as we saw last week, that the Lord is my shepherd. David is using imagery here. As a shepherd, as his background, to describe his relationship with God and our relationship with God, of what it should be like. There's been a lot of debate as to when this passage of Scripture, when Psalm 23 was written within David's life. Some have suggested that it was earlier in life while he was being pursued by Saul. Others believe it was later in life when he was being pursued by his son after being overthrown as king, and his son was out to kill him, and he's kind of reflecting back upon his life. We don't know that definitely one way or the other, but regardless, he is talking about the idea of struggle, pain, of suffering, of hardship. Things that we can relate to at any point in time in our lives. And so here we see in this passage, he begins and he says, he, being God, lets me lie down in green pastures. Now, some translations, the ESV, King James, others, says he makes me lie down in green pastures. The actual literal Hebrew is that he causes me to lie down in green pastures. You know, and the idea here of whether it's make or let or cause, you know, the idea is that it is of the Lord's initiative. God's the one that's doing this. God is the one who is bringing us and having us rest in the green pastures. You know, green pastures are the place of nourishment. Green pastures are a place of life. Green pastures are a place of comfort. It's you know, pastures that are dead and dying are not places that you would want to be. It's interesting too, because as David writes this, you know, he's writing this from the idea of being in the wilderness in his life. And you know, we don't in America, we don't really understand the idea of wilderness. But just think about having a bunch of sheep, and you're trying to find food for them, but there's no food because you're in the wilderness. It's dry, it's dirt, it's sand, it's rock. And the green pastures was kind of like the promised land. It was a place where you arrived and you said, you know, hey, I want to stay here. What's also interesting is that as he says here, he lets me or makes me or causes me to lie down in green pastures. You know, one of the interesting things about animals is that every animal in society, establishes sort of a dominance or a status within the group. For example, with chickens, we refer to it as pecking order, right? With cattle, it's referred to as horning order. Among sheep, it's referred to as butting order, because they will headbutt one another to show their dominance. You know, in deer, you know, the bucks will attack one another, you know, and things like that. So it's interesting, because when you think about that and put that into context of this passage here, you think of, you know, okay, in every society there are those within the society. So chickens or cattle or sheep or people, there's always those who desire to establish dominance. So thinking of sheep, the big sheep, the big dog, okay? The big sheep, the head of the butting order, though, does that head of that butting order, does he bring the sheep to the green pastures? No, he doesn't. He's just as lost as they are. And so by God here putting, or David here saying that God is the one who brings about the initiative. He brings them to the shepherd, is the one who brings them to the grassy meadow to have their eat, to eat their fill, to rest, to not be worried or concerned. And he says, God is the one who does that in our life. God is the one who brings us peace. God is the one who brings us rest. God is the one who brings us hope. God is the one who brings us sustenance physically and spiritually. You know, and he says, so follow the shepherd, listen to the shepherd. And he says, he leads me, again, there's that idea, but he leads me besides quiet waters. You know, sheep are very afraid of running water. They will not drink from a river, a running river. Rather, they'll drink from a quiet pool. And a good shepherd would never let his sheep drink from flowing water, because he knows that that brings about fear and anxiety. Philip Keller is a pastor, and he's author of several books. One of them that he wrote was that is the book called A Shepherd Looks at Psalm 23, because for 8 years, Philip Keller was actually a shepherd. And so as he writes this book, A Shepherd's Look at Psalm 23, and particularly this passage, one of the things he says is this. He says, sheep do not lie down easily. In fact, it's almost impossible for them to be made to lie down unless 4 requirements are met. Owing to their timidity, they refuse to lie down unless they are free of all fear. Because of the social behavior within the flock, sheep will not lie down unless they're free from friction from others of their kind. If tormented by flies or parasites, or sheep will not lie down. Only when free from these pests can they relax. Lastly, Keller writes, sheep will not lie down as long as they need are in need of finding food. They must be free from hunger. So he says, a sheep will not lie down, will not rest, unless he is free from fear, friction, flies, and famine. So this guy, Keller, must be a Baptist because he's got the alliteration down. You know, sheep must be free from all of these things. And he said, Keller says, only the shepherd can provide the trust, peace, deliverance, and pasture that is needed to free the sheep from all of them. A flock is restless, discontent, agitated, and disturbed when they don't have these things. And, you know, the same is true of people. You know, think about that for a second. How much of our lives is filled with fear or conflict with one another or something, you know, parasites or flies or those things that are leeching off of us and or biting us or tormenting us? What about spiritual and physical? What about spiritual hunger? You know, it's hard for us to realize that, you know, we are sheep. And just like the sheep that Keller talks about, we're the same way. We struggle with our fears, with our relationships, with the things that are always constantly causing us suffering and worry and anxiety and what we need to understand is that God is the one who brings us peace, resting in peace. We can't fix it ourselves. The government can't fix it ourselves for them, you know, for us. Our families, our intellect, none of these things can bring about the peace in our lives other than a relationship with God through Jesus Christ. You know, it's interesting that as David begins Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. Here, as he begins this, he talks about not about the activity of the sheep, but actually the working of the shepherd. He talks about rest for the sheep. He talks about what the shepherd brings and how the shepherd brings comfort and peace and joy and sustenance. He brings about all of these things. It's the shepherd who is the one who brings about these things, not the activity of the sheep. You know, and that's why we see in Mark 11:28, Jesus said, "Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you what? Rest." Jesus said, John 6:35, "I am the bread of life. He who comes to me will never go hungry, and he who believes in me will never be thirsty." Again, green pastures, quiet waters. Jesus said in John 14:27, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Do not give to one of you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid." Our ability to be free from fear is to rest in Him. You know, we experience a lot of anxiety in our lives, and I heard someone once say that, you know, the goal of life relates to anxiety is not the elimination of anxiety, because we'll never be able to eliminate the things that bring us anxiety, but rather it's the management of anxiety. And what the Bible reminds us of is that the only true way that that can happen is resting in God through a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. Well, next week we're going to look at verse 3 of chapter 23. Just want to remind you that our prayer emphasis for this week is to pray for a spiritual awakening within our community. Also, this coming Sunday, I hope that you'll join us for worship at 10:30, Bible study at 9:15 here at the church. Bring somebody with you and join us together. Also, we'll be celebrating our graduates this coming Sunday, so we We'll have some cake afterwards, give you a chance just to let them know how proud you are of them. And then the following week, the following Sunday, we'll be having a hamburger lunch takeaway, takeout, a lunch for our children's camp this summer. So we hope that you will remember and be reminded of these things as they move forward, and we hope to see you soon.